Daniel.
Already?
Yeah. I don't know where that came from.
You nervous? Getting choked up?
I am getting a little emotional.
Yeah, well, I'll walk you through it.
I don't know what to do.
When in doubt, drink whiskey.
Yeah, that's fair enough. This is a gift from Charles Stella.
Charles Stella, you magnificent bastard.
Fight.
So this is...
That's a good life lesson.
This is the worst.
When in doubt.
Drink whiskey. That's what I tell my sons.
Yeah. This is very light.
Yeah. So this is what happens when you don't get chill filtration and you don't get color added.
Yeah.
And it's only 6.5 years old.
Hold on.
In Scotland.
Hold on. This, I mean, it's damn near clear.
Yeah.
Maybe the
worst label design ever, by the way. You know what this is?
Obsession
is called. Almost impossible to read because the color of the whiskey.
Obsessio.
They did not account for the fact that this is going to be a light-colored whiskey. It's Laphroaig.
Bull. No.
Yes.
What?
It's a special edition Laphroaig bottled for an online store in Germany.
I just got really excited.
This is a 6.5-year-old Laphroaig. There's under 200 bottles of this in the world, just but I wanted to try it because I was interested in the idea of this.
So, with what we know about Laphroaig, Laphroaig 10 is the one you most often find on the shelves.
Yeah, and that one's totally reasonable. I mean, anywhere from $35, $40 a bottle.
It has a lot more color than this.
Yeah.
As
a matter of fact,
are they doing... I would be stunned if Laphroaig was adding the E150 caramel color.
Well, keep in mind... It's not as dark as you remember.
Oh, is it the bottle that I'm...
It's the bottle you remember.
Okay.
Right? Because look at that. It's definitely darker.
Yeah. I mean, that's actually whiskey
color. But four more years.
That's actually whiskey color.
Right.
This now, is damn near like new made clear.
Yeah, we're going to try the Laphroaig 10 to compare it because I'm just curious.
Oh.
But,
All right.
I wanted to try... So I know this is a rare whiskey technically, but it's Laphroaig and it's such an interesting idea.
No, it's like super interesting. Note, does Laphroaig 10, do those other things chill filter?
I don't know, actually.
I don't know. In the comments.
I don't think so.
Do they chill filter Laphroaig? Do they E150 Laphroaig? In the comments.
So this is 52.4% alcohol. This is a cask strength.
Oh, yeah.
Which makes me think maybe we should try the cask strength 10 instead of the 10.
We should try them all.
Could be the death of me. All right.
So
this is what happens when shops.
There's definitely Laphroaig character coming out of this. There is kind of like this thick, rich, new makey must.
I was gonna say it smells more like the new make stuff that we made,
but with
that slightly almost sour funk, right?
But there is that commonality. I want to not gloss over the actual Laphroaig elements that you know and love already.
It's all there. It's smoky. Yeah. It's briny.
Yeah, and I'm not really getting a particularly savory. Like a meaty ham note.
Yep.
I think that's something that it matures into, but definitely smoky, definitely briny.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. Almost like, and then what I think it turns into like these fruity sweetnesses.
Yeah.
I think right now it's like a sugary simple syrup sweetness.
Good morning.
Yeah, morning.
That is... Some serious morning whiskey.
Cask strength.
It's so oily.
It is.
This is a bourbon cask, not a wine cask. That's why it's so light. Right? Use bourbon cask.
Yeah. The sweet elements, I don't think those have matured into the sweeter things that we know and love in Laphroaig after you get past like the layers of
this
smoke.
This straight sickly sweet with a little bit of musty malt funk.
It's like the sweetness is almost like a simple syrup.
And then
like
smoked brine and...
Yeah. So it's interesting that the... core broad strokes of the elements are all there, but they haven't evolved, they haven't matured and aged into what people are familiar with in Laphroaig.
I'm gonna add just a little bit of water to this cask strength and see. And then we're gonna try.
Was there a cask strength Laphroaig?
I'm gonna get the cask strength Laphroaig 10.
You know what I like.
You know. Don't you?
Oh, a little bit of the water teases out more of the wood smoke element.
Uh-oh.
We don't have cash drink with Roy?
It might.
Is it in your office?
I don't know.
Did you take it home?
I thought I bought 2 bottles.
Scandalous.
I might have bought... No, I might have bought... This is the 10.
Wait, that's the 10.
Just the classic 10.
Did you already throw back the 10?
Yeah, you know. I put it back. Oh, no, no. This is the one I grabbed is the Cask Strength.
Okay.
Oh, okay. That's why I couldn't find it.
Oh.
Okay. So that's actually helpful.
So already on the nose, there's more of a like a caramel.
This is 58.6. Like
there is a vanilla caramel on the nose of the tin that hasn't really matured in the six yet. Get in there.
Oh, so much. Oh, whoa. I just got this blast of sunscreen.
What?
Yeah, like banana boat sunscreen. Like just quick and flash and the sun. Like,
oh, I see. No, no. See what I mean? What you're saying? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's bizarre.
It's just right on top.
Yeah.
It's surfing that ocean brine.
That's right. Woohoo! We're going out to South Padre Island. We're going to get us in that one little foot and a half wave break.
Yeah, that extra 4 years does a lot.
Oh, that's everything. But you know, they probably were blending a little bit of wine casks into this one too.
Oh, interesting.
As opposed to just pure bourbon cask.
Okay.
No, wow. With the water, again, you tried it, but...
I mean, I hope it's translating on camera how like incredibly lightly colored this is.
It's still sharp as shit compared to the Cask Strength 10, and it's lower proof. It's lower than the Cask Strength 10.
Okay. So what is the Cask Strength 10?
58. 58. And change.
Still, these are still very high.
Yeah, this is 52 and change-ish, right?
Right.
It's hard to read, but...
Let me put it this way.
52.4.
Cask Strength Isla.
Huh! Hey-ya!
That's gonna be... Yeah, you can get tossed around. You're gonna get your bits diddled.
Can you say diddled?
Oh, yeah.
On the family camera?
Diddled, it's just whatever meaning that you're prescribing to it.
Okay.
It's not what I meant.
Yeah, you meant...
I meant it in the wholesome
like drawing
way.
With crowns.
In the wholesome way. That's doodled.
Well, that's doodled.
That's doodled.
Oh, that's close.
You doodle?
No.
Oh, then they diddle.
And then I don't know. It depends on your definition, I guess. Mm. All right, we do have some comments, though.
Okay, hold on. Just to make sure, this wasn't like a day where we're going to go through and compare others. This was like the hero for the day?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, because I was like getting ready for it. I thought it was maybe a Friday episode.
Yeah.
Because this is rare. You're not going to get this. It's crap, how many more do I have to throw down in the next 10 minutes?
Yeah, well, the answer is... A lot, but not in the next 10 minutes, in the next 30 minutes.
Chris Ellis, a lot of people are talking about infinity bottles. My brother and I have another near end of bottle ritual. Okay, all right.
This is a good one.
When we get down to a couple of glasses remaining, re-gift the bottle to someone else, and then they get to try it without having to bottle an entire bottle of something, without having to buy Cask Strength Isla. Come on, people. Without having to buy an entire bottle of something they may not like. Oh! Yeah.
Come on! Not the most magnificent bastard thing you've ever heard
that
of?
That is such an NBA move. That's basically, you get through the
so
bottle.
So generous.
You get through the bottle.
Yeah.
And then, like the very last couple of pours, you give it to somebody.
You're like, you know what, you should try this.
That's an amazing thing that I'll never do.
I think it's a great idea. I'm going to drink to those guys.
Yes. Chris Ellis and your brother there. Wilderness Trail Kentucky Straight Bourbon.
Here's the thing. Yeah, okay, read that one and then I'll tell you something about that.
I've always wondered what both of you sound like when you're drunk. Well, thanks to the playback speed settings within YouTube, it's helped me get an idea of that, especially at the 0.5 speed.
Yeah.
So, do we talk slower? I don't know if I talk slower. I talk more. I don't know if I talk slower.
I don't know.
We haven't really been like drunk around each other.
No, not truly drunk. I haven't been truly drunk in a decade.
So, the next bastard's ball.
No.
That's the closing ceremony.
Not happening.
Get Daniel drunk.
No.
Get Daniel drunk.
That's actually less likely than cutting the beard.
Or the skullet? It's either or.
Skullet.
It's either.
That's terrible.
Skullet Daniel or get Daniel drunk.
Nope. This is not a binary situation.
I think it is.
So here's the one downside
and
of this whiskey. Are you ready?
The people agree.
Are you ready?
They're agreeing in the comments right now.
I'm going to just double check my numbers.
Are you team skullet or team drunk for Daniel?
Oh, Lord.
Drunk skullet for bonus points, Daniel.
Drunk skullet
for bonus
points. Ball. Okay, so here's the only downside of this bottling.
Yeah.
150 Euros.
Oh, this one.
Yeah.
Wow.
150 euros for a 6.5-year-old Lafroig.
I mean, it's rare, right?
The 10-year-old cask strength?
Right.
$70.
No, you're paying for the rarity. You're paying for the novelty.
You're paying for the novelty.
Right. Right on. That's super interesting, man. I like, the Charles, thank you so much. That's awesome. Here's to fighting, stealing, and drinking.
If you fight me, you fight for a friend.
If you steal me, you steal your liver's heart.
And if you drink,
may you drink with us.